to today's video, I'm gonna be showing you, well, not showing you, but I'm gonna be talking about my hair care regimen. Now, I got requested to do a hair regimen video. I can't remember who it was, but I got requested to do talk about what I do to my hair to, I guess, keep it healthy, whatever. But yeah, I'm just gonna be talking about what I do with my hair, how often I do it, and I'm gonna be showing you some of the products that I like to use on my hair. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. Okay, so I shampoo my hair once a week. I like to shampoo it every week with my Herbal Essence Hydrolicious shampoo. I can't remember what. I think they changed the formula. I got this one from Dollar General, and it was in the I think the clearance section where they was really trying to get rid of it. But this is the Hydrolicious reconditioning shampoo, and it's just a moisturizing shampoo. And I love this the shampoo. When I wash it, it really don't make my hair feel like all dried out, and it really just keeps my hair with this slip when I shampoo it and I wash it out and I run my fingers through it. It's not all tangled. So I really like this shampoo. It's a moisturizing shampoo, and I use this once every week. I normally wash my hair on Sundays, and like I try to do like a co-wash in between, but every Sunday I shampoo my hair with this moisturizing conditioner, and this is the one I use. And once again, it's by Herbal Essence, and it is the Hydrolicious. I can't get that out for nothing. It's the Hydrolicious. It's the Hydrolicious shampoo, and I love using this every week when I shampoo my hair. Now, once I shampoo my hair, I like to do depending on whether I need protein or not. I do my protein treatments once a month. So every month I do a protein treatment, and the protein treatment that I use is the Organic Root Stimulator Hair Mayonnaise, and I like to use this once a month. I like using this every month, and this got like I don't know what kind of smell is that. It got a smell to it. It's not like a terrible smell, but it's not like a really good smell either. But I use this once a month as my protein treatment. So this is what I use once a month, and I got this from Walmart. It was like $10, and I wasn't happy to spend $10 on this, but you know, whatever. I like it. It makes my hair feel real strong, especially after I get a fresh relaxer and I go and I'll use this behind it. It really just brings strength back to my hair, so I really, really like this. I use this once a month. Now for my weekly conditions, I use a moisturizing conditioner every week, because for my diet, I feel like I don't really need like a whole bunch of protein. I use protein once a month. I don't use protein every week. I have to use moisture every week because my hair gets really, really dry. And I've been talking about this product a lot lately. I love this. This is the Herbal Essence Hello Hydration. I love using this. This is my favorite moisturizing conditioner, y'all. This really just keeps my hair feeling so soft. Like, I ain't feel my hair this soft in probably like ever. when I use this conditioner, it really just makes my hair feel so soft, and it feels moisturized. And even when I wrap my hair up at night and then I wake up the next morning, my hair just still feel moisturized after I use this. So this is the, I think I've mentioned it already, it's the Herbal Essence Hello Hydration Moisturizing Conditioner. And I swear I love this, y'all. I don't know if they carry this in a bigger bottle, but if they do, I would definitely appreciate if you can tell me where I can find it, because I love it. I would buy this in a gallon jug if I can find it. But I love this conditioner, and it was $5. I got it from Dollar General. It was $5. I use this every week for my moisturizing conditioner, so I love this product. Now, I normally co-wash like in between shampoos. I usually co-wash like on a Wednesday, and when I do co-wash, I use the Suave Naturals conditioner. I normally use this on Wednesdays when I feel like I need to wash my hair, but I don't really want to shampoo it. I just want to just cleanse it just a little bit. I go and I use the Suave Naturals Orchid Petal. This is the scent I like to use because I like floral scents. I love this. It's been really, really good. And this is only like, how much was it? Like a dollar? I think it was like a dollar. I love using this because it's really, like really liquidy. It's not real thick, so. The way I use it is I put it in this applicator bottle. I got this from Walmart. It was like 99 cents or 89 cents or something like that. You can find these for like less than a dollar. But the way I use it is I put my conditioner in there, and then I probably put like three parts conditioner in like one part water, and then I'll just shake it up, shake it up like that, just to make it like extra watery. I don't want it too thick, and then I'll use the applicator and I'll put it like on my scalp, and then I'll just run my fingers through it, just to kind of massage it into my scalp, and then I'll just rinse it with cold water. Anytime I wash my hair, I always rinse it, do a final rinse with cold water, because I really feel like it just locks in the moisture. So I use this like in between my shampoos, like if I need to wash my hair and I don't feel like shampooing it, I'll just do a quick cold wash and then I'll just rinse it out and then just go ahead and blow dry it, or I just do a bantu knot out or whatever, how I'm wearing my hair. So for my leave-in, I love to use this actually. It's the Cantu Shea Butter. I know this has been real popular around YouTube. It's the leave-in conditioning repair cream, and I love this. This one is actually really, really thick. It's really, really thick. So I normally use this like on the ends of my hair, like when I rinse out my conditioner. And right before I get ready to do my blow dry, I'll put this on and then I'll just proceed with blow drying. But I really like this. This is the leave-in that I like to use, and it's the Cantu Leave-In Repair Conditioning Cream. Now once a week, what I like to do is I like to put shea butter on my scalp, and it's not really a certain brand. I just like to take 100% shea butter, you know, the ones that come in like the chunks. I take that and I'll just whip it up and I make my own little concoction, and I like to use this on my scalp. As you can see, I need to make some more, but I just take shea butter and I whip it up and I put it on my scalp every Sunday when I shampoo and deep condition my hair. I like to put shea butter on my scalp because it just really, putting oil on my scalp really just don't do nothing for my hair. My scalp just really drinks it up like water on the desert, like for real. Oil don't do nothing for my scalp, so I like to use shea butter. It's real thick and it just really, it stays on my hair. I don't have to worry about my hair getting real, real dry, because my hair gets really, really dry. I don't know why, it just does. So I like to put shea butter on my scalp. Now for my oil moisturizer, I like to use the Organic Root Stimulator Olive Oil Professional. Incredibly rich. It's basically the same as the small bottle, it's just in a big bottle, I think. Anyway, I don't think it's a difference, but it's just in a bigger bottle. And this is like I said, the Organic Root Stimulator Olive Oil, incredibly rich oil moisturizing hair lotion. I love using this. It's really thick and it keeps my hair feeling moisturized, so I really, really love this. So once again, I'll do a run through of everything that I do. It's really not much that I do. I shampoo my hair once a week, every week, with the moisturizing conditioner, with my moisturizing conditioner. And once I shampoo my hair with that, I'll go behind it with my Hello Hydration. I just mix that in with some coconut oil and some avocado oil, and I put that all over my hair. I put my plastic cap on, and then I sit under the dryer for about 30-35 minutes, and then I rinse that out with cold water. And then once I rinse that out, I will go and I will use my leave-in, my Cantu Shea Butter leave-in. I'll use that, just a little bit of that on the ends of my hair, and then I'll take some more avocado oil and I'll put it on my hair. And that's if I'm blow drying. Sometimes I blow dry, sometimes I don't, but I like to take the avocado oil and I put it on my hair, and then I'll blow dry it, blow dry my hair all the way out. And in between shampoos, I take my Suave Naturals and I cold wash in between, probably like on a Wednesday, like if I need to wash my hair and I really just don't feel like doing a whole bunch, I just do a quick cold wash, and I use the Suave Naturals conditioner, and I just use that with my applicator bottle, and I just put it all over my hair and I massage it in, and then I'll go and rinse it out with cold water. And once a month, I'll use my protein treatment, the Organic Root Stimulators Hair Mayonnaise. I like to use this once a month, because like I said, I feel like I don't really need like a whole bunch of protein in my hair care products, because I take vitamins and I get a lot of protein in my diet, so I feel like I don't really need a whole bunch of protein in my products. Because if I do use like a light protein every week, my hair will get really, really extra dry, being that it's already dry, you know, as it is. I feel like my hair will get really extra dry if I use like a light protein every week, so I just use this protein treatment once a month. And like I said, I'll take some shea butter and I'll put this on my scalp. But I just put that on my scalp every week, and it just keeps my hair feeling, it keeps from getting dry before the next week comes. And as far as styling, I mostly wear my hair like in a bun, either back in a bun or up in a bun like this one. I normally just wear my hair up. I don't really wear it down too much. I don't really flat iron it too much either. And when I do style it, I use my organic root stimulator olive oil smoothing whole pudding. I like to use this on my edges, and I when I want to lay my edges down when I'm like 10 weeks post, like actually now I need, I'm like 10 weeks post, I put this on the edges of my hair, and then I just brush it in with a boar bristle brush. My brush is over there. I like to brush it in, and then I'll take one of those mesh wraps, and I'll just like lay it on my edges just to keep my edges laying down. That way when I put my hair back, it won't be really, really frizzy. So that's basically all I do to my hair. I don't think I left nothing out. I think I mentioned everything in the video. So I think that's about it. Thank y'all for watching, and I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.